Hi everyone, Ian Van Tuyl here, and behind me is a new listing of mine in Ventura Harbor. This is a 2015 Blue Jacket 40. This is a very incredible performance cruiser. So let me show you some features and benefits that this yacht has to offer. Okay, so here we are on the starboard side, and as you can see, this is one beautiful vessel sitting here in the slip. This is a rare Blue Jacket 40. This is a very well-known performance cruiser, Tim Jacket design. It really possesses all of the quality that you would expect with an island packet yacht, and the performance that you see with Tim Jacket's designs. Starting out at the bow, we have this beautiful quick anchor here, stainless steel. Look at the attention to detail with all the beautiful stainless work that's been done up here. We have the larger head sail, inner self tacker right behind that. LED navigation lights, very sturdy bow pulpit there. And again, a beautiful blue painted hull, light blue boot bottom paint. There is a red boot stripe, and again, the integrated windows here. And one thing that I'm really impressed on is, even when looking at the side decks themselves, I mean, just the walk around, the convenience, the ease, and accessibility up to the foredeck. Very large Harkin Traveler here. The other thing is you have control of your main sheet from both starboard and port. And again, with these outboard shrouds, it allows you to walk up to the foredeck with ease. And again, really nice high-end Bomar stainless steel hatches. We have access up to the windlass here with an up and down switch. Really nice anchor system with a swivel. But again, this just shows you the attention to detail that's been brought in to this vessel. As we move our way back aft, you see the beautiful topside lines here. We have the classic mainsail here with this Park Avenue style boom, the Harkin back car system, and again, Sparkraft double spreader mast. Just beautiful clean lines. I like the large stack pack here, making it very easy to manage this sail. And then as we move our way back aft, we have the Iverson Dodger connector and bimini. Built-in stainless steel grab handles here. The B&G radar and the KVH LTE-1 system off of that pole back there. Going into the cockpit, okay, I just want to give you a nice perspective of this. Really nice high-end backrest, nice cockpit table that can be folded down so it's out of the way if so desired. Moving our way back aft, you can see the Edson pedestals. Nice easy access out to the back of the vessel. And then again, when that's not desired, this closes off, locks into position down here and the opposite side. We have the swim ladder that's integrated underneath this hatch right here, and a great, nice, easy access to the back swim platform. Hydraulic backstay adjuster off to the starboard side. One thing I really like about this is our throttle controls are on the starboard side. We also have access to the two-speed Harkin electric winch, our bow thruster controller here, really big, thick steering wheel. And again, just a beautiful layout on this. We have this integrated compass here, and then our Simrad autopilot controller. At the port helm, we have a B&G multifunction display. We also have the compass built in. Again, really nice pedestals. Below the seat backs here, you have a really nice storage. Again, everything's finished off really nicely. And just even the stainless trim that they use is just pretty remarkable. Centrally located, this is our engine displays. So we have 276 hours on this Yanmar engine. We have the temp, the oil, our bilge pump alarm, and our fuel gauge right here. We also have a clip-in for the VHF ram mic. Again, really comfortable boat. There's also, you know, the two-speed electric winch here, but you have access to your jib sheet clutch, your main sheet clutch here, And again, it just really encompasses a nice vessel to shorthand or single hand sail. Underneath this, you'll see from the photographs, this is a large storage locker. And again, as we move up to the cabin top, we have a electric cabin top winch off to the starboard side for the main halyard, reef, vang, traveler. And then off to the port side, we have our main spare, which is like spinnaker, halyard, reefing two, outhaul, and traveler. We also have a rain multifunction display over the companionway hatch. But wanting to kind of show off the companionway, again, the attention to detail, the woodwork, the integrated handles here, and just how this system works is really clever and quite tastefully done. As we come down below the vessel, we have the galley off to the starboard side, and very nice, easy companionway steps. The galley is set up very, very high-end, in my opinion, with the Force 10 two-burner stove and oven. We have these really nice top-loading fridge and freezer compartments. Beautiful Corian countertops, double stainless steel sinks, nice high-end fixtures. And again, just all the beveled edges for not only handholds while you're in the galley, but just as placement for stuff so it doesn't fly off. Large storage compartment there, microwave, again, shelves with fiddles in them, storage racks here for plates and what have you. And again, this is a really nice little cabinet nook over here, just utilizing a lot of space for storage in the galley. Behind these little shelves, you can see how it's all finished out. Really nice high-end fixtures throughout. And then our Spectra water maker gauge here. This is our feed water pressure. So you can see that. 110 outlet here with GFI breaker, you know, so it's properly done. And what I really like about the engine room access is right here, you get a look at the Raycor filter, has a pressure gauge here at the top of it. But again, just beautiful engine, which you'll see more pictures in the full listing. As we kind of go through the galley, just again, storage, and again, everything is finished out. So it's a true island packet yacht with the quality, integrity of everything. And again, just one heck of a racing machine or performance machine on the Tim Jacket side. All right, so the nav station is directly across from the galley. We have our tank monitoring system down here, bilge switch. As we move on up, again, just that inlaid wood, beautiful woodwork throughout. We have the VHF. This is a standard Horizon VHF with AIS GPS integration. We have our 110 side, our 12 volt side, a B&G, a chart plotter display down here. And again, as we move our way up, looking at the portholes, again, the detailing throughout the vessel really just blows me away. The salon itself is quite large, and it's also convertible with the salon table, how that's also integrated. Very known, again, from this design. On the island packet side, where this folds up out of the way, you can create a really nice salon area and just opens the boat up. But when you so want it, this folds down and you have room for six people. I mean, it is impressive. But looking at the materials that are used, really nice high-end blue leather. Coming down below here, we have our battery switches, our DC main switch, and again, just little reset fuses. But nice, done, easy, convenient. The woodwork behind the seating again, and how everything is just finished out. Truly impressive with the lighting as well too, that's on our rheostat control. And then as we move our way kind of down through the main salon, I really want to point out these floors. I mean, I am just in love with these floors. These are just gorgeous about how everything is set up and done. And easy access down into the bilge compartment itself. And then you also have a plug there. So if you wanted a table, that can easily be done with like a little small, you know, cocktail table. Looking out the starboard side of the salon, again, from the lighting, the fixtures, the woodwork, this nice deep seating with real comfortable high-end foam. We come up here, this is our Webasto diesel heater, a thermostat control. So you have vents throughout the boat for diesel heating. This is the mast, because this is a keel-stepped mast. So that's coming right down. But it, you know, again, that high powder coated, you know, glossy look just really adds to the traditionalness. And then as we come into the forward head and shower compartment, again, what a great use of space here. I like how they've also changed up with a lighter blue on the quarry in here, a nice sink. We also have the electric flush toilet. And then what's really cool is behind this plexiglass door, this all encompasses out. So you can actually have a fully enclosed shower. So again, really nice, a good feature here, really good, you know, design. And then again, when that's not in use, that folds up behind the way here. We have our fixtures in our shower, nice bench seat here, a little shelving. They thought of everything with, you know, even it can drain here for shampoos and what have you. Additional storage underneath the sink. And again, it's all push button on the flush and so forth. The other nice point about this is you have access into the forward V-berth. But before I go there, I just kind of want to show you these doors and how they're louvered out here. Great for ventilation. But again, the trim work and the attention to detail is really impressive. And I just, when I go through this boat and know its performance and know its, you know, pedigree behind that, and then, you know, you come down below and it's just really impressive just to kind of see this. So again, this video is not doing it justice, but I hope you guys can feel and see just what I'm looking at. A really nice large V-berth. So this is a quite a large V-berth here. We have shelving on both sides. Again, that really nice lighting effect with that shiplap type of paneling off to the side. And again, large storage and shelving throughout. These are our dimmers here for the lights. So you can kind of see how that kind of dims out. So in the evening, this really just sets it off. Large hanging locker closet here. And then obviously this folding door that clips out of the way really is impressive. So coming back through the salon, you can see all of these opening ports. Again, so you have lots of ventilation throughout the vessel. That's one thing that they've done really well on this boat, is to be able to open everything up and just create massive amounts of ventilation throughout the vessel itself. That plus the diesel heater, I mean, it's again, it's a win-win. Overhead handles allows you to be able to walk throughout the vessel, you know, anywhere, have something to hold on to. And then, all right, so coming into the aft cabin, we have a hanging locker here, a bench seat. Again, great amount of space to kind of get in here, sit down, pivot into bed. There are three overhead opening hatches, which is really nice. And again, a large berth here, access to additional storage points as well too. We also have access into the engine room compartment from here. And again, this is giving us view of our Balmar alternator, our regulator, and a really nice clean install. Well, I hope you found this video to be helpful and informative. I know I covered a lot of things in a short period of time, but please see the link below for the full photo shoot, the detailed information on the vessel itself. And again, if you liked the video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't, please subscribe to my channel for additional video walkthroughs like this. I look forward to hearing from you and hopefully earning your business. Thank you again.